try to use the time that we have a little bit to explain the avodah of Chodesh Elul and the preparation that Elul is for Rosh Hashanah. The B'nai Soschar talks about the 3 months of Tammuz, Av, and Elul. The 3 months of Tammuz, Av, and Elul have something in common. That Chazal tell us that Esav and Yaakov took the 12 months of the year, 6 for Yaakov and 6 for Esav. Nisan, year 7, Yaakov, Tammuz, Av, and Elul for Esav. And Yaakov Avinu was Yodai Echezes Ba'akev Esav, and he took the months of Elul for himself. So the Bnei Soschar points out the following inyan. The shame of the Ribbono Shel Olam, the shame Aleph Dalet Nun Yud, has in it 12 letters. Aleph is 3 letters, Dalet is 3 letters, Nun is 3 letters, and Yud is 3 letters. The Chodesh Nisan starts with the letter Aleph, and that's how the 12 months of the year go through the Shem Aleph, Dalet, Nun, Yud. On this Cheshvan, Chodesh Tammuz is a Dalet, Chodesh Av is a Lamed, and Chodesh Elul is a Tov. A different Cheshvan makes the Bnei Soschar based on its Sefer Yetzirah. The month of Tammuz is the Koyach of Riyah, the month of Av is the Koyach of Shmiah, and the month of Elul is the Koyach of Asiyah. So the Bnei Soschar points out the following. Chodesh Tammuz and Av are a Dalet and a Lamed, which are Dal. Chodesh Tammuz and Av are Riyah and Shmiah, which are Rosh. Both of them point to an inyan of anius, and an inyan which points to a chisarin, which those are the months of Tammuz and Av. What do we have to do in Chodesh Elul? We add a tof to the word dal, and it becomes delas. We add an ayin to the rosh, and it becomes shar. And we open up in Elul a delas, a door, and a shar to the Ribbono Shel Olam. And he points out in the Lashon of Slichus, we say, Kedalim ukurashim dafaknu dlasecha, that it points to this inyan of Chodesh Elul. So it's a beautiful remez from the Bnei Soschar, which needs explanation what our avodah Chodesh Elul is. He points to 2 letters that we have to work in Chodesh Elul, a tof to form a delas, an ayin to form a shar, to open up dlosos and shiarim for us by the Heilige Ribbono Shel Olam. So maybe we could look at this Bnei Soschar and cut out our Aveda of Elul, looking at those 2 letters of tof and ayin. In this week's parasha, we finish the parasha with the kriya of Melchemes Amalek. And there's no mikra that we read the parasha of Melchemes Amalek before Rosh Hashanah and in Chodesh Elul, because it's exactly what Chodesh Elul is about. We know that Chazal tell us that as long as Amalek is here, Ein Hashem Shalem Vein HaKisei Shalem. Kisei. The kisei of the Ribbono Shel Olam, the world, is not shalem. Which kisei is not shalem? The kisei of Malchus Shamayim. Amalek is the one who does not let Malchus Shamayim be nizgala in its complete. If Rosh Hashanah is a day of izgalus of Malchus Shamayim, if Avodas Hayoyim of Rosh Hashanah is Malchus, and as pointed out in our Gedaliyahu, that we paskin, that we say Malchius in Kedushas Hayoim, Zichreinus and Shaifres are our own bracha. Malchius, we say together with Kedushas Hayoim, which points out that that is Avodas Hayoim, that the Avoda of the day is Malchius. We understand that in order there should be an Isgalus of Malchius, we have to have Kisavir Memsheles Zodoin Min Haaretz. As the Ramchal points out in his Biur Amalchius Zichreinus Shaifres, that Memsheles Zodoin refers to Amalek. And when there'll be Kisavir Memsheles Zodoin Min Haaretz, then it will be Vesimloich Atohu Hashem Levadecha. Then Malchus Shamayim will be in its complete. So what is the Avodah of Chodesh Elul? Taking away whatever disturbs Malchus Shamayim and whatever is Ma'akev Malchus Shamayim from being Nisgala. So we realize clearly that the Avodah of Chodesh Elul is to get rid of Amalek, which Amalek is the one who disturbs and doesn't let Malchus Shamayim to be in its gala, in its complete. Therefore, the Avodah in Chodesh Elul is taka the kriya of this week's parasha. It's taka complete in the Avodah. Ki seitzei lamolchama aloivecha is the beginning of the parasha, and the end of the parasha teaches us which molchama are we talking about, the molchama l'Hashem ba'amalek. Why? Because it's Ma'akev Malchus Shamayim. We know from the Vilna Goyin that it teaches what we say in the Musif of Yontif, Galei Kveid Malchuscha. The Vilna Goyin tells us that Baruch Shem Kveid Malchusei Le'olam Vaed are six letters which are the six wings of a Malach. The six wings of a Malach are Mechuvon, the six words of Baruch Shem Kveid Malchusei Le'olam Vaed. And the middle two wings are closed, as the Gemara tells us. Which two wings are closed? Kveid Malchusei. And that we are Mispalel Galei Kveid Malchuscha. Open up and be Megale, the Kveid of Malchus Shamayim, which are those two words of Kveid Malchusei, which are covered in Galus. So we realize, who covers Kveid Malchusei in Galus? Amalek is the one who covers Kveid Malchusei in Galus. So let us see a Remez Nifle. Tammuz and Av are the months of Esav. Who is Esav's greatest koyach? Amalek. So what are the koyach of Tammuz and Av? Rosh and Dal. Rosh and Dal are the numerical value of Kveid Malchusei. That is what Amalek and Esav Arasha have a koyach in the months of Tammuz and Av to cause a heder, a missing in the world of Kveid Malchusei. It's dull and rush. The world is poor because the world doesn't have this galus of Kveid Malchus Shamayim. That's the dull and rush of Tammuz and Av. That's what the Dalet and Lamed and Resh and Shin of Tammuz and Av point to, that Kveid Malchusei Yisbarech is not in its Shleimus. And now we understand what the Avodah of Elul is. Ayin and Tov, look how interesting. The word Amalek, if we write out Amalek as is Mavuyer in all Svarim HaKadoshim, Amalek, Ayin, Mem, Lamed, Kuf, adds up to Ace, Tov, Ayin, 470. So the Avodah in Chodesh Elul is Mechuvin to Tov and Ayin, because if we will do the Avodah of overcoming Amalek and overcoming the Koyach of Amalek, we will, instead of Dal and Rosh, we will open up a door and a Shar for its Galus of Malchus Shamayim, and then we will be Zeicha to this galus of Kveit Malchusei in its shleimus of a simlech atuhu Hashem levadecha. So we realize what the avodah of Chodesh Elul is. The avodah of Chodesh Elul is to be megala Kveit Malchusei Yisbarach on the world and to open up the delus and the shar for that is galus of Kveit Malchus Shamayim. We still have to work on how we open up that isgalus of Malchus Shamayim and more to concentrate more on what our Aveda is. First, let us go back and understand what we said over from the Gra, that the six wings of the Malach are Baruch Shem Kveid Malchusei La'olam Vaed. The Koznetz Magid in Avedas Yisrael points out a very interesting nekuda. There are six letters that we can attach to the name of the Ribbono Shel Olam. Yud Kei Vav Kei has six letters that we can attach to the beginning of Yud Kei Vav Kei. We can say Ba Hashem, She Hashem, Ki Hashem, Me Hashem, Li Hashem, V'Hashem. Those are the six letters that add on to the Shem Yud Kei Vav Kei. Look how he points out. Baruch starts with a beis, Shem starts with a shin, Kveid starts with a chaf, Mem is Malchusei, Lamed is La'olam, and Vav is Va'ed. What are the wings, so to say, that bring out the Kveid Shamayim in the Bria, that bring out the Ribbono Shel Olam in the Bria? Which letters can connect us to Yud Kei Vav Kei? Six letters. Beis for Baruch, Shin for Shem, and so further. So we understand that the wings of a Malach, which the wings are what are Megala Kveid Malchus Shamayim in the Bria, are the six letters which bring out Baruch Shem Kveid Malchusei La'olam Vaed. Two letters or two words are missing, says the Gra, Kveid Malchusei, which are the Chof of Kah Hashem and the Mem of Me Hashem. Maybe we have a right to say the following words. Ba Hashem, She Hashem, La Hashem, Ve Hashem are all letters that connect to Yud Kei Vav Kei. The Chof and the Mem have a special meaning. Ka Hashem, how do we refer the Chof when we use the Chof together with the Yud Kei Vav Kei? In a lashon of Mika Hashem, who is like the Ribbono Shel Olam? There is no comparison to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Me Hashem is the understanding that everything is from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That is exactly what's covered in Galus. Two very important nekudas of pure emuna. The pure emuna of Kah Hashem. There is nothing besides the Eibishter in the world. There is only the Eibishter in the world. That's the Chof of Mi Kah Hashem. The Mem of Me Hashem is the emuna and the avoda of emuna, that nothing else, there is nowhere else that we get anything from except from Hashem. And those are the two emunos that are covered in Galus. Teva, Amalek, for one, is the one who says everything in this world is Teva, everything in this world is Mikra, and that belief that everything is Mei Hashem and nothing comes from anywhere else, and there is no koyach in the Bria that compares to Hashem in its smoke in no way whatsoever. That clarity in Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, that clarity is covered in Galus. And that's the avoid of the Chof and the Mem. That is our avoid of Ka Hashem and Me Hashem. The clarity in realizing that Chof and that Mem, that is our avodah, and that is our avodah that's cut out for us to bring out that clarity in its fullest. Let us go a little bit further and see more what avodah of Chodesh Elul is. In Imrei Noyam, on Hoshana Rabbah, he points out a very interesting nekuda about Elul. The word Elul, everybody knows, is a loy and a loy. Loy with an aleph and loy with a vav. And many Torah is said on it. But the Imrei Noyam points out a davar nifla. He says, take the loy with an aleph and the loy with a vav and multiply 31 by 36. Take the lamed aleph, the kale, and multiply it by 36 times, you will get 1116, which is the gematria of Keser Malchus. That is what it says in Imrei Noyam. It's a most magnificent Imrei Noyam. But what does that mean to us? What is our avodah that lies in the Imrei Noyam, besides the beauty of the Imrei Noyam? In Sefer Bris Kuhunas Eilam talks about this number of 1116 of Keser Malchus. And he says the following: 6 times Mokoim is also 1116. Meaning that a person's emunah has to be clear that on all 6 sides, as we know when we say Shema Yisrael Hashem Echad, Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, we have to be ma'amin that the Eibishter is Lamaila and Lamata, and the Eibishter is on Mairev and Mizrach and Dorim, and the Eibishter is on Tzofin, all 4 sides and Lamaila and Lamata, which are the Vov Ktzavos, the 6 sides. That is what 6 times Mokoim means. I have to realize that the Eibishter is Mekoimoi Shel Oilam. Mekoimoi is Mokoim Vov. That the Eibishter is on all 6 sides of me. And there is nothing without the Eibishter. Less Asar Ponu Minei. There is nowhere where the Eibishter doesn't exist. And that is the Emunah, the clarity in Emunah that Elul Zavoide is. 6 times Mokoim, to be able to be Mamin Bemuna Shleima, that less Asar Poni Minei. There is nowhere without the Ribbono Shel Olam, and the Ribbono Shel Olam is Mamalek Kol Almin, and Seivev Kol Almin, and takes me from all 6 sides, it's only the Eibishter. Then Amun of Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echot, to be Mamin the Echot, the Alamailo and Lamato, and from the Dalit sides, that's what 6 times Mokoim refers to. And that's what Elul is about. Elul is about 36 times Kale, which is 1116, which is 6 times Mokoim. Because that's the opposite of Amalek. That's the Avodah, to be Oiker Amalek, and to realize that the Eibishter is all over. In order to come to that reality, our avodah in Elul is to bring down the gaiva of Amalek. Because to realize that the Eibishter is with us in all 6 sides, one has to be able to see the Ribbono Shel Olam around him. And in Chodesh Elul, we have the ability to realize that there is a Ribbono Shel Olam. And that is our avodah in Elul, to clarify by ourselves our emunah in shleimus of emunah, and to be oiker the Amalek. And then we will make a shar and a delus for Malchus Shamayim and be megalek void Malchus Yisbarach in the world. will be Megala, the Ribbono Shel Olam, in the world. It will no more be Dal and Rosh, but it will be Kvod Malchusei. That is our Aveda. Keser Malchus is the Aveda of Elul. Kaviyachol, when it comes Rosh Hashanah, we have to be Mablich the Eibishte, and we have to see that the Keser of Malchus, which Keser Malchus means that everybody realizes the Malchus, because Vayosum Keser Malchus al Reisha is the mitzius of crowning a king, is how, as it says in Megillas Esther, Vayosem Keser Malchus al Reisha. So too, Kaviyochel, when it comes to Rosh Hashanah, we have to be able to put Kaviyochel the Keser Malchus. And that's the Avodah of Elul, as the Rebbe the Pnei Menachem pointed out, that it says in Pirkei Avos, in Perikin Yon Torah, Malchus nikne b'shloishim mailos, meaning in the 30 days of Elul. In the 30 days of Elul, we can be koine Malchus Shamayim and be koivea the Keser Malchus through our Avodah of Elul, of being oiker da Amalek and instilling in ourselves the clarity of Emuna Asedah HaRibbeinu Shel Olam on the world. That is our Avodah. Let us look and go a step further in the practical Avodah of Elul. One of the minhagim that are brought already in Peskim is the minig of Tkiyas Shofar. We know that the minig of Tkiyas Shofar in Elul, there is a minig for Rosh Chodesh Elul based on a Torah, Pirkei de Rabbi Elazar, and there is a minig to blow Shofar all of Elul. A Dover Pele, which everybody should know. For some reason or other, we look at it as a minik, and we don't think twice of missing it if we have to run out of shul before Shofar Blazen. It's not the Shofar of Rosh Hashanah that we have to be so worried about. That's until this week I opened up a sefer called Avas Yisrael from the Vizhnitz Rebbe, from Rabbi Yisrael of Vizhnitz. And he writes in the first piece in Parsha Shoftim something that's an eye-opener. The Iker HaMtokis HaDinim of Chodesh Tishrei of Rosh Hashanah. The Iker weight that the Eibishter should go Mikisei Din to Kisei Rachmim is from the Tkiyas Shofar B'Yimei HaElul. The Tkiyas Shofar in Elul is what's Ma'oyre Rachmim by the Ribbono Shel Olam. Why? What does the Rosh Hashanah, the Avodah of Elul, do? What is this Tkiyas Shofar of Elul? The Sfas Emes points out that Yemei Elul are Yemei Mulchama. It's not Bichinam that in Parshas Shoftim we learned about Kiseitzei La Mulchama, and in Parshas Kiseitzei we have more than once Mulchama, Kiseitzei Mulchama, Kiseitzei Machne, Melchemes Amalek. Constantly Mulchama, because that is the Avodah of Yemei Elul. The Avodah of Yemei Elul is Mulchama. Zog the Heilige Sfas Emes. In Parshas Baloischa, we learn that when we go out to the Mulchama, we blow Chatzetzreis. And that is the Shofar of Elul, is the Shofar of the Chatzetzreis of Mulchama. I have a Meiridike Kasha on this Sfas Emes. The Kotzke Rebbe brought in Shemeshmuel points out, Kiseitzei la Mulchama aleivecha, why doesn't the Torah talk again about Chatzetzreis? And the Kotzke Rebbe answered, so brings the Shemeshmuel. There is a very big difference when a Mulchama comes in your territory or you go fight a Mulchama by the other person's territory, by your Yosoinis' territory. Parshas Baloischa is talking about Kisavoyu Mulchama Ba'artzechem. You're in trouble already, Zakti Kotzke Rebbe, if the Mulchama has entered your land and has crossed your borders and you're fighting for your own life, because the Sina has already entered your town. Then you have to have Chatzetzreis. But kiseitze la molchama aleivecha. If you go out and fight on the other person's land, on the other person's, over your borders, you cross your borders into the other person's territory, then you don't need chatzaitzreis because you have the upper hand. I think that if we hear this word of a Kotzke Rebbe, we'll understand what this Vasemis is telling us. Many of us live in a illusion that we are living in Kiseitze Lamolchama Aleivecha. We blow Shofar and Elul to teach us that the Sinai has already invaded us. We're not holding by Kiseitze Lamolchama Aleivecha. We're holding already by Kisavoyu Mechama Ba'artzechem. The Mechama has already entered your Artzechem. The Mechama has already come into your own territory. And you're in trouble. And that's what Shofar is here for. Shofar is here to remind you what the Mechama is. The Mechama is not Kiseitze. The Mechama is already holding by Kisavoyu Mechama Ba'artzechem. And that will give the person the shiflus, that he realizes how much he has to work. I saw a piece of Beis Yisrael which sent a poshita reminder. Everybody knows that the element of surprise is what gives an enemy an ability to overcome. The one who wins Melchama is the one who's prepared. The one who's ill-prepared and surprised by the kayach of the Melchama loses. Zogt der Rebbe de Beis Yisrael, Rosh Hashanah is a day that we have to have a Melchama with all the Mekatrigim, with all those that want to be Mekatrig. And if we're not going to wake up in Elul to prepare ourselves, then waking up on Rosh Hashanah is much too late. And that is why we blow Shofar and Elul, to wake us up to prepare for the Melchama. What is this Melchama that we are going to have on Rosh Hashanah? Rabbi Yitzchak Isaac Chover, from Cheder Agra, Talmud of the Goyim, says a Dover Nifla in a Rabbi Shuvah Drasha, that il be'emes change our attitude to Rosh Hashanah. Everybody knows a pasuk in Iyuv, Vayevoyu b'nei elikim, l'siyatze v'al elikim. It goes on Rosh Hashanah, Vayi ayoyim, Zer Rosh Hashanah. All the mekatrigim, all the koichos elyoinim come to be mekatrig. Why? Zok Rabbi Yitzchak Isaac Chover, Dvarim, Pshutim, which need a lot of explanation. We know from Nefesh HaChaim, Shar Aleph, from Sefer Derech Hashem, from Ramchal, we know that they teach us that a person's maisim don't end in the Talid Amis on this world. A person with his maisim reaches all the way up till Shamayim, all the way up till Kisei HaKavod. Every single person does affects all the way till the Kisei HaKavod. And when a person does a mitzvah, he brings more light to all the olamos, more koichos to all the olamos, more ha'aras ponim in the lashon of the Derech Hashem. And when a person does the opposite, chas v'shalom, the person brings darkness in all the worlds, Richuk in all the worlds, Hester upon him in all the worlds. So now listen to Dvarim Neiroim that Rabbi Yitzchak Isaac Chover teaches us. When it comes Rosh Hashanah, come all the Koichos Elyonim and are mekatrig on a person and tell the Rebbeinu Shel Olam, these people with their Averos caused us damage, we're Baleidinim. We have a din Torah with the person. Hafla v'fela, they're coming with a taina that we want mazik them. We ruined them. We caused them hezik. They became rochek from the Ribbono Shel Olam. Instead of aras upon him, there's hester upon him. Instead of ur, there's choshech. Instead of koichos, there's heder koichos. So they're balei dinim. They're balei dinim to come to a din Torah and say that we have a tviyah to Klal Yisrael. That Klal Yisrael caused us damage. What kind of different look we have now on Rosh Hashanah. We have to go to din. With who? With all the koichos elyonim. With all the koichos elyonim we have to go to din. So we realize how much we have to prepare ourselves and how much that shofar has to be a wake-up call and how much that shofar has to wake us up from our slumber and our sleep. That we have to remember that we have to prepare ourselves for this milchama. How do we prepare ourselves for this milchama? How do we prepare ourselves for this milchama? What is the preparation for this kitruk? What is the way to prepare ourselves for this kitruk? There's one way to prepare ourselves for this kitruk. To be mispalel for his galus of Malchus Shamayim. And to work in Elul to be mekariv the keser of Malchus. Because when there's Nizgala Keser Malchus, all the Mekatrigim don't have what to say. Because on a day of Keser Malchus, the Mekatrigim can't talk. As everybody knows, Malchus de Rikia ke'en Malchus de Ara. And in Malchus de Ara, when there's a day of coronation of a king, and a day of Simcha of a king, the king doesn't listen to Mekatrigim on that day because that's the day of his coronation. If anything, he pardons everybody. So as much as we are oisik in being mamlich de Eibishter in Chodesh Elul, and not chas v'shalom doing the opposite. No, we work on being mamlich de Ribbono Shel Olam in Chodesh Elul, and we work on being megalim Malchus Shamayim in Chodesh Elul, and we concentrate on Malchus Shamayim in Chodesh Elul, and we prepare ourselves for the day of Malchius, of being mamlich de Eibishter. That's how much we can be megala the midah of keser, that the Eibishter Kaviyachol is megala his keser of Malchus on that day, and the Mekatrigim can't come. And that is our way that we go out to L'Mochama. That is our avodah of going out to L'Mochama. That is the only way we can go out to L'Mochama. That's our only hope to go out to L'Mochama, is to elevate ourselves, to concentrate on bringing out Malchus Shamayim. And that is our avodah. And it's an avodah that is a constant avodah in Elul, to realize that in Elul, we forget about ourselves and we forget about what we need. We remember one thing, ani ledoidi. My whole ani, my whole concentration is only ledoidi, only for the Ribbono Shel Olam, and only for Malchus Shamayim, and only to be Megala Malchus Shamayim. That is our concentration and that is our avodah. And practically speaking, we have it cut out for us in a very easy way. That every single thing that we do, at least in Avodas Hashem, a bracha, every time we make a bracha and we say the words Melech HaOlam, at least in Chodesh Elul, to think for a minute that the Eibishter is king over the universe. And king of the universe means that there is nowhere where he doesn't exist, and realize that he exists in all the koimos, and there's nowhere where I can run away from him. As David HaMelech says in Tehillim, Ono miponecha evrach, I have nowhere to run away from you. Im esak shamayim shamato, im mitziya shi'ol hineka. To live in Elul with the hakara that the Eibishter is Melech of the world and he runs the world and everything is Mei Hashem and there's nothing Ka Hashem. And then we'll be Megala Kvod Malchusay in the Bria. And then we will be able to be Megala the Ribbono Shel Olam in the Bria. That is our Avodah and that's the Avodah that's cut out for us. And if we'll do that Avodah and we'll work on that Avodah, then we will be able to really the zoicha in Yom Adin, that we will not focus on the kitrug, nor will focus on the gilui of Malchus Shamayim in the Bria. That is the Aveda that we have to prepare ourselves for. And if we remember that, that ki is shofar of every day, that ki is shofar of every day could be also a remembrance that we're going to be mamlech the Eibishter with that shofar on Rosh Hashanah, and we're practicing that malchus. We're practicing that malchus. It says in Briskunas Olam, shofar is begematria melech malchus. What do we have from that gematria? What does it mean? It's begematria melech malchus. The Eibishter is melech without us. But the malchus of the Eibishter, the hakara of his malchus, that's melech malchus. It's not enough that the Eibishter is melech. The Eibishter wants that melech should have a malchus, because that's the rotzin of the Ribbono Shel Olam, as is in the first piece of our Gedaliah on Rosh Hashanah. Rotzin Hashem is, he wants to have a malchus. And with the shofar, we are koveya his malchus in the Bria. And that's the shofar of Elul, to remind us that the Eibishter is melech, and we are part of his malchus. And we have to be mamlechim 24/7, and remember that the Eibishter is melech al kol ha'olam. And with that, we will be zeicha, that we will see b'karav b'yameinu, this galus of malchus ha'yizbarach in the Bria. Let's go back for a minute and go a little bit deeper in the remez of the ayin and tof of Chodesh Elul. We know that the Goyin tells us that a word, a letter, is only in its full meaning when you take the milui of a letter, meaning that an ayin is only an ayin together with its milui. An ayin is ayin yud nun 130. A tof is 416. Together, they are 546. What is this mispar of 546, which is the avoda of Elul? The word 546, the number 546 is mosaik, sweet. There is mar in the Bria, and there is mosaik in the Bria. There is mar in the Bria, there is a bitter life in the Bria, and there is a life in the Bria of Mesikus. Amalek is mar. Amalek is begematria mar. Amalek looks like everything is sweet. He covers all the bitterness of this world, all the bad of this world, in a covering of sweetness. As it says in Pasuk, Samim mar lemosaik. They make mar, and they make the mar look like it's mosaik. Our avoda in Chodesh Elul is to clarify by us what is mosaik and what is mar. What is bitter and what is sweet. We have to, in Chodesh Elul, realize that Avodas Hashem is not only something that we have to do, but Avodas Hashem is mosaik. Avodas Hashem is something that has in it not bitterness and not bittersweet, but Avodas Hashem is mosaik. Avodas Hashem is something that is as sweet as could be. We know that on Rosh Hashanah we are toivel b'dvash. The difference between mar and mosaik is dvash. And that is our avodah in Chodesh Elul, to realize the mesikus of Yiddishkeit, the geschmack of Yiddishkeit, that there is nothing more sweeter than Yiddishkeit. That is our avodah. Amalek tells us that Yiddishkeit is a ol, a shekorcha baderech. He cooled you down. He made it something that is hard for you to do. Amalek tells you that Yiddishkeit is a hard avoda. It's something that doesn't sell you anything good. We have what to give you. We have what to sell for you. In the avoda of Elul is to chazer in ourselves the nekuda that Yiddishkeit is mosaik. Yiddishkeit is something that is sweet. And then we will think fakert. We will know what's mar and what's mosaik. We'll know what is bitter and we'll know what is sweet. That is the avoida of Rosh Hashanah, of the dvash. And if we're not going to prepare ourselves in Elul, that dvash won't have any meaning. Because the only way that dvash will have a meaning is if we realize what is mar and what is masaik. We'll realize that all that we have in Olam Hazeh, no matter how the chain of it is, after all said and done, it's sheker achein vehevel ayoifi. It all is sheker and all it's hevel. The whole outside chain, the whole outside mesikus is really mar. That's one nekuda of the dvash. To go down, take off the dvash out of the mosaic and realize it's mar. And then take the dvash and realize that what is mar is not mar, but it's really mosaic. The Yiddishkeit that you think is an ol, the Yiddishkeit that you think is something that's hard for you, realize that it's mosaic. The last Radzimina Rebbe said a pshat in a Rashi in Rosh Hashanah. Rashi on Daf Chof Ches talks about the inyan of mitzvahs lav lehonos nitnu. Rashi says, le'oil al tzavareyem nitnu. Zog de Radzimina Rebbe, on the tzavar you wear a tachshit, a oil you put on the kotev. Why does Rashi say, le'oil al tzavareyem nitnu? Because Rashi is teaching you that the oil ha-mitzvahs is our tachshit. The oil ha-mitzvahs is what we have as a tachshit, not as an oil. Because we don't look at Torah mitzvahs as an oil. We look at Torah mitzvahs as a tachshit. And I heard a nosaf of it from the Mashgiach in Baranovich, Zechet Tzadik V'Kadosh Levracha Rabbi Yisrael Yaakov. The Gemara says, Rechayim al tzavaroi v'yasek b'Torah. Zokter, aval the person has to have rechayim. Aval the person has to go work. But if it's al tzavaroi, if the rechayim is his tachshit, then he can't be v'yasek b'teira. If he's going to carry around the rechayim and not realize it's an ol, he's going to look at that as a tachshit, that will not let him be Isaac in Torah. So our avoda in Chodesh Elul is to realize what is the ol and what is the tachshit, what is mar and what is mosaik. That is our avoda in Chodesh Elul. And with that we will overcome the mar of Amalek and will be margish the mesikus and will be zeicha to the devash of Rosh Hashanah, which is the sweetness of Rosh Hashanah, that we should be zeicha to Hashanah Toiva Umesuka, a mesuka to be margish the mesikos of Yiddishkeit and be zeicha to see with our own eyes when the Eibshter will be megala malchusei Yisbarach in the world.